islands in the sun, islands in the fun. Welcome, welcome one and all to the land of death. Trinity to the bone, Trinity to the bone. When they come to Bacchanal, well, they can't be. The brethren, they full of energy. Some people say God is a trinity. Paradise, I'm not convincingly. God gave us a spirit fiery. But nothing in the world will bother we. But look a smart man, God with green money. We still come out and mash up the party. Sweet, sweet TNT. Oh, how I love up this country. Sweet, sweet TNT. No place in this world I'd rather be.
Sweet, sweet TNT.
Oh, how I love up my country. Sweet, sweet TNT.
Russell, definitely. It's a day that, you know, been long in coming. You made the flight over to Trinidad to what officially should be your tenure with the TTFF and the national team, and your reactions to how things have gone.
No, absolutely delighted. You know, this is a great opportunity for me. I've always felt that there's a lot that I have to offer in a coaching capacity, and so given this opportunity, I obviously jumped at it. Yeah, great opportunity. As I said, there's a lot I think that I have to offer in a coaching capacity, and you know, it's a good opportunity where we are at the minute. We have a good chance of qualifying for the World Cup, so hopefully I can come in and provide that spark that helps get us there.
All right, what is the transition going to be like now for you? I'm sure you've prepared yourself mentally for this. Over the past few months, having to make that switch now. Tell us what's going to happen. I mean, for Falkirk days, is it over? You're going to keep some sort of attachment there? You're going to move over to Trinidad on a full-time basis?
I have to be fully committed to getting us to the World Cup. So I think what is definitely going to happen is I would still have roots in Falkirk and a lot of friends there. I've spent 5-6 wonderful years at that club. But the job at hand now is the national team, so I'd come back here and be home here as much as possible and try to get us to a level that would make sure that we qualify. Basically, you know, I think in the last rounds, whoever watched the team could see that we had a lot of talent, but I think there was a lack of organization and cohesiveness in the team, and I think if we can put that together in the next few months, then you know, we'd have a good chance of any.
When you look at the group that we're going into on starting February 11th, first game on the road, it's going to be in Central America, El Salvador. You've been through that scenario before. How do you sum up in terms of, you know, what our approach should be like and how we're going to take the next 10 games?
I think obviously we have to do our homework and you know, and know what the other teams, what are their strengths and weaknesses. But in saying that, I think that we have to know what is our own strengths and weaknesses, and we have to play to our strengths and build on our weaknesses. I think again, we are a big team, and possibly it's we have to use that to our advantage. Sometimes it's not the nicest to look at, but again, football is a game of results, you know. And if we have that in our arsenal, we have to use it. You know, we've probably got at one time on the pitch we can have 5, 6, 7 players who are over 6 foot. So I suppose that at times, you know, if we're under the cosh a bit, we might have to go a bit back to front and use things like long throws and that sort of stuff. So, you know, it's just things that I'll have to bounce off the manager, and hopefully we can come to an understanding and start working and stuff like that.
If the opportunity presents itself or is required, your input on the field of play, can we still see Russell Latapy wearing that strip, wearing that number 10 on the pitch with Trinidad?
Yeah, obviously, as I said before, I have to be wholeheartedly coming into this situation. That's the only way I know how to do things. So in saying that, if the manager sees fit and I'm making decisions along with him, seeing that I'm needed to go on or to start or to play or whatever, then I'd be more than happy to do that like I've done in the past. What I will do though is in the next coming weeks, as best as I can, get myself in top physical condition. So if called upon, I'll be ready.
And you're going to join us officially from early next month, as it starts Saturday New Year, as we go ahead into South America to prepare for this game against El Salvador?
Yes, what is going to happen is I would have to go back up and basically put my affairs in order, and as soon as I can get that sorted, and I mean I'm speaking to you but haven't really spoken to the club about the situation as yet as well. So as soon as I can get that sort of affairs in order, then I'll be back down. So hopefully come into an agreement with Mr. Warren and the association. I can start working on that straight away, and hopefully in the first week or so, first 7th, 8th, 9th, somewhere around there, I should be back.
I'm seeing this glow in your face, obviously. First time now, this position. You must have a bit of extra excitement inside of you. Tell us a bit how you feel now knowing that this opportunity is there for you.
Nah, fantastic, Sean. It's, I knew from a very long time ago that I wanted the opportunity to manage my national team. You know, once I decided to stay into football in a coaching capacity, I know that I wanted to. And that's the highest level you can manage. So, you know, so having the opportunity now, I'm delighted. It's an opportunity for me to come back home and be involved in local football as well, and see players and hopefully get them to the national team and improve their game and try my best to raise the whole standard of football in Trinidad. You know, I think that we're one of the superpowers of Caribbean football, and I think we have to maintain that. And I think with the methods that I've used working away, I think if I can try and implement that here, then our football would stay at a good standard for a long time, and that is my aim.
Russell, we obviously look forward to working with you now, and best wishes.
Cheers.